They also lost today against a fantastic Japan side who really just blew me away with how well organized they were, how disciplined they were.
Japan will do the exact same thing against everyone in the World Cup. And Japan traditionally do really well because Japan put out their team with a game plan. Like they were trying to get something out of this as if there was something on the line. And I think that was the first indicator of, like you said, we got punched in the face.
皆さんこんにちは。日本対アメリカのパート1の動画500ライクありがとうございます。このパート2の動画に300ライクいただければ、エクアドール戦のプレビュー動画投稿します。その動画では、エクアドールや南米のサポーターが日本代表について語る動画をアップロードします。今回の動画は、日本対アメリカのパート2の、動画になりますので、こちらはアメリカのサポーターが日本代表について語る動画になります。
With Columbus, but I feel like Japan let our center backs have the ball.
Yeah,
right? they gave you that 20 yards. So it's kind of like if I'm Matt Turner, of course I'm going to pass it out.
You're going to pass it to them.
Of course.
But what I'm saying is
they cut out everything else.
Japan put out their team with a game plan. Like they were trying to get something out of this as if there was something on the line. And I think that was the first indicator of, like you said, we got punched in the face. And we couldn't figure it out in real time. It got a little bit better in the second half. Yes, there's still the question of like Ferreira getting his chance at the very beginning. Does that change things? I don't know. I still think I'm happy that this team got punched in the face the way that
they
did because it is a piece of humble pie they're going to have to react from, right? Because we do constantly talk about how good our team is and how where our players play and things like that. Japan has good players too. But more than anything, Japan's a good team. And if you don't think that everybody that's in World Cup is a good team at a minimum, plus the good players, you are out of your mind. And you will find yourself 3-and-out in a World Cup because Japan will do the exact same thing against everyone in the World Cup. And Japan traditionally do really well because they fight like hell. They're organized and they're not going to give you anything for free. And we then have to be able to say, okay, Japan is quote unquote the better team today. Where are we going to get our chances from? It's not working for us. Yes, they're letting our center backs have the ball. One, why didn't we think that would be the case? Of course they are, especially if they're going to press. Where do you think they're going to press? The people who are not best on the ball to force turnovers. So then where's the answer, right? Where's the solution? Hey, guys, if we're getting pinned back over and over again, let's just lump it long a few times, push our lines up, scrap for second balls, win the battle in the middle part of the field, reestablish and try something different. And I think it took far too long to do that. And
they also lost today against a fantastic Japan side who really just blew me away with how well organized they were, how disciplined they were, the football that they played. It was very, very pretty. Two goals, one thanks to Daichi Kamada, the 26-year-old Frankfurt attacker. He scored a lovely goal that was obviously checked by video review. Apparently it wasn't there, but then it was there. Great finish from him. And then Mitoma scored in the 88th minute to wrap things up. His fifth national team goal, the Brighton and Hove Albion player.
They crap themselves. I don't know how to say this. I know it's a family show. They crap themselves. There's other words to describe that. They absolutely crap themselves. A lot of the chances Japan had, credit to them, came from the press, and the midfield was overrun.
Certainly, I kind of felt like on the commentary there was a little bit of a stereotype, and we all probably indulge with this in how what we think of Japan, and we don't think of them as a team that can bully their opposition. Mm. But guess what? This
year, こちらがパート2の動画になりました。パート1の動画には多くの視聴者からコメントを、いただいたんですけれども、ほとんどのコメントがそのアメリカ戦の日本には本当はプランがなかったのではということも多くの視聴者がそのようなコメントを残していましたが、本当に皆さんはそう思いますか？そして日本は、いつもと違って442のフォーメーションで、この一戦に挑んだのでプランがなかっただとは、まあ、個人的にはあんまり思えないんですけど、本当に皆さんはそう思っているのか、それとも森保監督のことを、どうしても批判したいからそういうコメントを残しているか、まあ、正直に思っていることをこのコメント欄に書いていただければと思います。でアメリカのサポーターは日本代表のプレーをすごく称賛していて、組織としてプレスをかけていた、まあ、1人や2人の選手ではなくて全員でプレスをかけていて、きちんとしたチームだなということも話していました。本当にチームワークのあるプレーができたというふうに話していました。スーパースターの選手がいないが、一人一人の選手はまあいい高い質を持っていて技術のある選手であり、プレスを全員でかけるっていうことを 話していましたが、そのように、皆さんは思いますか？日本にはスーパースターがいないと思いますか？で、あとはその日本代表はそのワールドカップに向けてドイツや、スペイン、コスタリカと対戦するときに 4-4-2 のフォーメーションで行くと思いますか？あのアメリカ戦で見せたその戦術というか、4-4-2 のフォーメーションはワールドカップに向けての、準備というか準備だったのでしょうか？皆さんの意見をコメント欄に教えていただければと思います。そして最後に、前の動画でも話したように、そのパート1の動画でも話したようにスコア予想ランキングのルール変更があり、4点以上の予想をした場合は、2ポイントとしてカウントします。で、4点以上というのは例えばなんだけど3対2、4対1、5対0とか、まあ、とにかく4点以上の予想をすれば2ポイントになりますので、1-0、2-0、2-1 の結果の方が、予想しやすいということで、ちょっとルールを変えようかなと思いました。皆さんが、ルールこのルールについて反対なのであれば、それについてもコメント欄に、書いていただければと思います。いつも本当にご視聴ありがとうございます。そしてこの数週間後だけで、もう2000人近く、登録者が増えましたので、これからもよろしくお願いいたします。これからも本当に、多くのLIKEとチャンネル登録もよろしくお願いいたします。そしてチャンネル登録した後に通知もオンにしていただければ、新しい動画がアップロードされるたびに通知が届きますので、新しい動画を見逃すことはないです。では300LIKEでまたエクアドール戦のプレビュー動画をアップロードします。